This is the new bulb compressor from Crazy Tube Circuits in Greece, and the bulb compressor is a pedal which features 25 volts DC of internal headroom and a hand-picked photo cell to give you very high-quality, studio-quality optical compression. It features four controls and an internal depth switch which with which to tame the top end a little bit if you're going to use it into, say, a high-gain distortion amplifier. This guitar is a Pro Guitar Shop Total Tone 56 Relic, available only from Pro Guitar Shop, and we're running through to the clean channel of a Laney VH100R. Bridge pickup sounds like this. Neck pickup. All right, let's have a listen to what the bulb does with that clean tone. It's so smooth, there's hardly any bloom at all, and I know it's very hard to demonstrate a high-quality compressor such as this on YouTube because of the nature of YouTube, but I'm going to do my best. I can feel that it's shaving off a little bit of the highs, it's smoothing out the tone, it's getting rid of those spikes, but there's none of this bloom stuff that you sometimes get with other compressors. Now, all of these controls are very important and work interactively with each other. The input gain especially actually drives the input of the pedal. I've got it at about 2 o'clock because these pickups aren't very high output. If I was running EMGs or humbuckers or something like that, I'd probably back it off a little bit because the more input gain, the more you're going to get natural compression. The compress knob sets the amount of gain reduction of the input signal. The ratio will go from a fairly transparent 1-to-1 or no compression at all, let me show you, through to 20-to-1. So this is the pedal off. So when you've got the ratio backed all the way back like that, you could probably use it as a clean boost almost. If I crank it up to, say, halfway, we're going to get roughly a 10-to-1 ratio. You can hear the squeeziness come in, and then you'll want to turn your volume up to make up that gain, also known as make up gain. If I crank the ratio up even further, it's going to get squeezier still, and that will mean that probably I'll need to have more makeup gain, hence the volume knob. It is just so smooth. I'm going to play a single note just with the guitar and no pedals, and we'll see how long it hangs on for, and then we'll give it some bulb treatment. Get the idea? And on and on and on. Let's crank the amp's channel into drive. And give it the bulb as well. Back the ratio off a little bit for more headroom. That means it's going to attack the amp harder, especially if we've got the volume louder. So, again, the amp on its own. Bulb. It's so nice. That sounds cliche, doesn't it? But it really is. This is a very special compressor. Chris has done a wonderful job. I'm going to hit an Eventide H9 delay in the shimmer sound now. It sounds like this. Pretty damn good on its own, really, but if I kick the bulb in as well, it's just going to flatten it out and let me play the long, languid notes. Yeah. I could sit here and do that all day long, really. And in fact, I did make another video using just those two pedals, and it sounds, well, good enough, I thought, to put up on YouTube. You'll see it later on. Inside the bulb, you'll find a little dip switch on the PCB board. That dip switch ships in the factory up position, which means that its tone control is as default. If you switch it down, it will shave a little bit of the highs off, smooth it out a little bit for use with high gain distortion amps and things like that. I like it as is. This is a great compressor, Chris. Well done. Check it out, people. I think you'll be impressed. See ya.